Today's guitar lesson has been highly requested from one of my viewers, Marcus, so thank you so much. Tablature does not show you how long to hold the notes, nor does it show you what fingers that you're supposed to use, but it does tell you where to place your fingers, so you still have to use your ear when reading guitar tablature. Hey guys, welcome back, or if this is your first time here, my name is Brandon, and welcome to A Place for Melodic Metal Guitarists. The resources for this guitar lesson are linked in the description below, so be sure that you pause the video and download those things, because I'm going to be referencing a sheet that I've made with examples in it, and of course there'll be some jam tracks for you as well that you can jam along with. Okay, so we can see in our example 1A, this is getting you started and getting you introduced into the canvas itself that you would write guitar tablature on or that you would read it. What you're going to see is that we are tuned to drop D. So instead of just standard E tuning, we've got the lowest string down tuned to the same as the fourth string. So now in example 1A, you're looking at a representation of guitar strings. How we read guitar tablature is we read everything from left to right. The top one is always going to be your highest note on your guitar, and then the bottom one is always going to be the lowest. So we're looking at it from this angle. So if you look at your guitar, you're looking at it upside down. You're not looking at it from the perspective that you're looking at me. So in example 1B, you'll notice that we have two representations. We have notes that are stacked on top of each other, and then we have notes that are more in a succession. So the numbers that are, of course, in a succession, we play those notes separately or maybe arpeggiated depending on the context. But of course, at the beginning of example 1B, that you notice that those notes are all stacked on top of each other, so that means that it's a chord, it's a group. So you're gonna play these notes all at the same time. So these numbers are representing actually what fret numbers you're playing. So anytime you see a zero, that means that it is an open note, an open string like this. And if we have a number like a 2 or a 3, that's the fret. And then so from there, you just have to see, okay, well, what string are we on? In the example 1B, we have a D chord. So the first three notes are all open, so they would sound like this, respectively. And then the next one you'll see on the G string, you're playing the second fret. Okay, so here's the G string and the second fret. And then we have on the B string, that next string down, we have the third fret. Okay, and then after that, another open string. So when you play all of it together, and then of course in the second part of that example 1B, you can see that they're all separate, so we're playing it as an arpeggiated sequence. So now our next example, 2A, we're gonna actually start playing a song. So this might be a chorus of a song. We've basically got two sets of eight notes. So we got 16 notes on the first two bars. We've got playing like an open with the high 14. Okay, so what we've learned so far, we got, so 0, 0, 0, and then we're playing the 14th fret G string, so. So if you want to think of it in sets of fours, that's fine. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So it would sound like this. And then the next set, you'll notice we have 3, 3, 3, 5, and that's just like a power chord down here with an extended note. And this one is played 16 times as well. And then following that, we're playing a derivative of that previous chord. 2, 3, 2, 5. Playing that 16 times, or four sets of fours. Now this next part might be a little confusing to some. First, I'll let you hear what it's supposed to sound like, and then we'll make more sense. How I count it down in my head is, I know that, okay, 5, 5, 5, 7. I play that 6 times, and then I play its second part 6 times also, and that was 7, 7, 7, 10. And that's followed by 4 strokes of the 7, 7, 7, 9. And if you're looking at the tablature, you can see what I'm talking about. I'm just literally counting the notes out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4. and then follow that with a... Now, you may notice that X in example 2A at the very end with the open, and that's just to signify that you need to make sure to not play that last note. You're just playing the last three bottom strings. Now, in the jam track, you actually play this twice before you play the last note, so just so you know that it does repeat. So I'm gonna play the jam track now at the slowest speed that I have right now available, which should be about 110 BPMs as opposed to the full speed 160. That's pretty much all there is to it, to the basics of guitar rhythms on tabs. Now, where it gets a little bit more complicated and confusing could be the guitar solo, and that's a lot of the times because a lot of people just have a different way of notating on guitar tabs. What we're going to see first in example 2B is the 7th fret on the G string. So you'll notice that little slant. So when you see a slant that is slanting up, like an up ramp, that means you're supposed to slide up to the note. And of course, if you have the backward slant, that means that you're supposed to slide down. So we're gonna be playing a guitar solo over our jam track that we're making. So the first note is the 7th fret on the G string, and we're gonna slide up to that note. Guitar tabs don't tell you how long you're supposed to hold a note, so you have to use context. You still have to use your ear. So let me help you with the interpretation of these first two bars. We've got 7, 9, 10, 8, 10. This is what it's supposed to sound like. And every now and then you're gonna see little squiggles, little tildes, and those are supposed to signify vibrato on the guitar. So the next thing you're gonna see is the 11P10. P means pull off, and if you ever see H, that's hammer on, but I'm getting ahead of myself. What we're gonna do with that 11P10 is we're gonna pull off from the 11th to the 10th fret. So it's gonna be like, and then you're gonna go down to the 8th fret. So far, we have on our song. Now here is where we're gonna see the H, so hammer on and pull off. We have 9H10P9, so that's gonna be starting on the 9th fret, hammer on to the 10th and pull off to the 9th, all with one pick attack. So, and the pick attack is gonna be on the first time. So it'll be like this. After that motion, we're gonna go to the 12th fret, that on the D string. And then we have to slide down to the 5th fret real quick. And when we do it, as we're about to play the note, it gives, you know, a nice little nuance. I'm gonna do some vibrato after that. Then we're gonna come down to some other notation. We've seen the X before, that's the dead note. And that's just there to make things a little bit more interesting, and I'll show you how we're gonna use that in context. You'll notice B. Now, B stands for bending, and it tells you what you're supposed to bend up to. Now, you see 10, B12, that doesn't mean that you play the 12th fret, actually. You just play the 10th fret, and you bend up to the 12th fret, so it's the same note. So it's like, okay, you've got that note, and you want to bend up as though you're playing this note next. So it'd be like this. So since we have these notes stacked on top of each other, this is what it's gonna sound like. And we're gonna do a little bit of vibrato on the end. You'll notice we're supposed to play this two times. So it's gonna be the rake or dead note followed by... That's how we're supposed to play it. And then the next time we come to this type of notation, instead of the 8th fret on the B string, it's the 10th fret. So move that up, and then also move up two frets on the G string. So you're starting on the 12th fret there, and you're bending up to the 14th. So. But you'll notice that we have an extra notation at the end. We've got 12B, 14R, 12. The R means to release. So instead of doing the little vibrato at the end, we're actually going to release the note right after we played it. So it's like... And that is to set us up for our next note. You know, you can see is the 11th fret G string. Now let's just mix a few of our techniques that we've learned so far. This being the case, we're gonna slide and then do a hammer-on. So we're gonna slide from the 9th to the 11th fret. And do a hammer-on to the 12th, like that. Following that, a vibrato. This next bit is going to be different than what we've encountered so far. This is gonna take a lot of practice. So in this notation, you see PB, which is the pre-bend, 17, R15. In this specific notation, we're supposed to look at the 15th fret for guidance as to what fret are we supposed to play, because that's what we release back to. Basically, you're on the B string and you are bent up to the 17th fret from the 15th, like this. Then we release it just like that. So after we hold out our 13th fret note, we're gonna do kind of a quick run, and you'll notice we have a new notation yet again, PM, which means palm muting. So just resting the palm, or we know the side of our hand on these strings here just a little bit, just to mute some of the strings. So we're gonna play these notes in quick succession, starting from the 5th string. And then after we get to the B string, we release the palm muting and just play normally. And now it's time to show you the guitar solo in full at the slow speed of 110 BPMs. And now, of course, full speed for both. Let's do the rhythms first. This for sure wasn't meant to be a comprehensive lesson, only a getting started. So if you need more help, there are a lot of resources online. I've linked a few in the description below. And if you, of course, have any questions, definitely ask me and I'll definitely help you any way I can. I hope you guys enjoyed the spin that I did on this lesson, kind of in a metal context. And if you want to support this channel in any way, I have a Patreon, patreon.com/BrandonBurch. That gives you access to some bonus features and also videos early. So if that is something that you're interested in, donate $1 a month and you get access to lots of cool stuff. Thank you guys so much for watching, and y'all have a great weekend. I'll see you Wednesday.